I mean, certainly mistakes, you know, by us as well, but that's part of it. You know, that's why we practice. We're out here, you know, pushing ourselves to get better and to improve. And, you know, we've had, you know, some really good days. We've had, you know, some days where, you know, we haven't been quite up to the standard, but that's how the season's going to go. You know, it's not going to be just smooth sailing all the way. So days like today are good to learn from. I also think there's a lot of positives too, you know. Whenever you go back and watch the practices, yeah, there's things we can clean up, but a lot of good things we did as well. And our defense is playing well, you know, and that's good to see. We're going against you know, a really good unit with talented players, you know, and that's gonna make us get better, and it's good. Unfortunately, you're gonna have days where they get you sometimes. They got us a few times today. We got them a few times, but you know, that's what good teams do. There's back and forth and give and take.
You know, I just feel like, you know, we were a really good defense last year. Obviously, added some great pieces. So, and then obviously with just a new perspective with Coach Gus, it's really just, you know, trying to build on everything we was last year and really becoming that elite defense. Obviously, we've been talking about, you know, making that step for the last couple of years. It's about time we really put, you know, that to the test and really do that. So I think our whole mindset when we come out there is just really be the best defense in the league every day. And I think that's just how we all, you know, especially with, you know, 5-3 not being out there, everybody just trying to raise their level of play.
So I feel like we've been coming out there, doing what we have to do, man, stopping the offense, helping them get better and, like, helping them be the dominant offense they known to be. So it made me feel great, man. Like, I could go to my locker, sit back, kick my feet up, because I done did my part.
Hello, this is Joel A. Erickson and Nate Adkins, Colts insiders for the Indy Star. We're out here at Grand Park where they got back on the practice field. This is Sunday, full house today. Second time we've had a full house sellout. A lot of people there and a rough day for the Colts offense. And not just the first teamers, pretty much all around, 6 or 7 drops, something like that. A fumble from Nyheim Hines, just a lot of mistakes left and right from the offense today.
Yeah, today was probably the worst day for them so far, but I've noticed since the pads came on, the defense has really caught up to it. It's just, we keep bringing it up, but it's a couple of veterans that just keep kind of forcing their way. It's Stephon Gilmore and it's Yannick Ngakoue, and they're just not letting up. DeForest Buckner's had moments like that too. They're just overwhelming this offense right now at times. Some of it makes sense. If they're going to practice at that level, the receivers, we always knew they weren't as up to par. The secondary looks phenomenal. So it's a mixed bag because I think some of it's the defense is showing this. They really have potential to be great. At the same time, though, some of these errors, like they can't drop passes the way they did. They can't miss assignments the way they did. So it was just a bad practice for them.
One of the interesting things, though, about the drops and specifically is Matt Ryan is sort of famously a stickler for the details and pretty hard on guys with stuff, but I asked him about the drops and he said physical mistakes, he's always felt like guys are going to make those. Guys, you're not perfect. And so he said when someone has a drop, and I'd have to go back and look through my notes, but it wasn't necessarily like one guy had 3 drops today. It was kind of all over the place. He said when a guy has a drop, you come back in the huddle and it's more like, okay, you'll get him the next time. It's more encouraging. The stuff that gets him going is the mental stuff. That's where he said when a guy comes back in the huddle after a mental assignment, it's like, come on, we got to get this right. Like, it's just a different approach to the way he handles different mistakes. And I think the point is just mental mistakes. Ryan feels like with enough preparation, you can avoid those. You're not going to have any of those if with enough preparation. The physical mistakes, he just views as no one is perfect at everything. And it's just an interesting insight into the mind of the Colts' new quarterback.
Yeah, and just the approach to, or the commitment to process right now over immediate results. I mean, that's what I think all great quarterbacks find a way to do, but all players too, because this is training camp. They've still got weeks to be out here. They're going to get into the preseason. Like, they're not going to play a real game until September. So some of this you got to understand, like, yeah, the mental mistakes, that'd be not putting in the time and the work. But a lot of the guys who are struggling are rookies or young players or guys who do lack either physical strength and ability, or they just haven't, maybe they're not as sharp yet catching the football or getting leverage on blocks. So it's all a process. They've just got to find a way to keep confidence while they're trying to get better.
The other thing is it's only one day out of 20-something out here. They're going to be out here for a full month. We'll be back tomorrow for the Indy Star. I am Colts insider Joel A. Erickson. This has been Nate Adkins.